On the streets of Uganda's capital, Big Brother is watching.
Our manpower, especially in as far as the forensic investigators is concerned, is still wanting. It is still wanting, and unfortunately, it is majorly concentrated around town.
Chinese telecom giant Huawei recently installed a closed-circuit television system in Kampala that police say will reduce a recent uptick in violent crime. This $126 million system, equipped with facial recognition technology, keeps an unblinking eye on the streets below, all legal and authorized by Uganda's president. Security analyst Will Carter says it has tremendous potential to be abused.
So in many ways, it depends on who's using it and how they choose to use it, and what kinds of governance structures are in place to protect people. But it also depends on how that technology is built and implemented and how the vendors actually deploy it. So Huawei is responsible to some degree for who they sell this to and how they build it.
Popular performer and parliamentarian Bobby Wine is a frequent government critic who says Uganda's cyber surveillance unit set out to hack him after he was arrested in 2018 and charged with treason. Wine said he was tortured in prison and after seeking treatment in the United States, returned to Uganda. A Wall Street Journal report quotes a senior officer in the cyber surveillance unit who says Huawei technicians in Kampala hacked Wine's WhatsApp account. Authorities interfered with street rallies Wine organized and arrested him and dozens of his supporters. Reaction to CCTV monitoring is mixed.
They should be used for the right purpose, not any other thing. But as of now, I think they are being used for the, because we've seen a few cases that have been brought up because of these CCTV cameras. But I think they need to be used even more, and more should be even installed.
It's a military government. They're not really up to giving up power just like that. So they have to protect themselves. And one of the ways that they could do that, it's easy to track you as an individual when where they are not through using cameras.
You cannot ignore the complicity of the local authorities, who I suspect are the ones who are actually engaged in the abuses. But I think there's also a very strong argument to be made that Huawei knows that a lot of their customers are going to engage in this activity. And if they provide this capability, it's going to be abused. And I really do think that in that sense, they are very culpable and complicit for these abuses when they happen.
Huawei says it does not engage in hacking and complies with local laws and regulations. The company says it has so far installed camera systems in 700 cities across more than 100 countries. For Arash Arabasadi, this is Jeff Custer, VOA News, Washington.